Let's now talk about the most important mathematical relation in radioactivity, that is radioactive decay law. About it we can write that this law relates activity of a radioactive substance to the number of parent nuclei at an instant. This law helps us a lot in mathematically defining lot many things related to radioactivity. We can write it is stated as at any instant, first we'll define it and then we'll understand the mathematical applications of it. At any instant, activity of a radioactive substance is directly proportional to the number of undecayed nuclei. Undecayed nuclei are the parent nuclei which we already studied in the substance at that instant. So here we can write if at t equals to 0 there were n naught nuclei and at time t n are left undecayed. That means in the duration from 0 to t, n naught minus n would have been transformed to daughter nuclei, those who have decayed by emission of radioactive radiations. And further we can write from time t to t plus dt, if dn nuclei will more decay, this implies activity of substance at time t is, this we can write, activity is equals to mod of dn by dt, which we already studied. That if n time dt dn nuclei are decaying, that means at this instant, the instantaneous value of activity will be dn by dt. And in this situation, more precisely, it should be written as minus dn by dt. Now, this activity, according to the law, if we just have a look at any instant, activity of a radioactive substance is directly proportional to the number of undecayed nuclei at that instant. That means at this instant, if n are left undecayed. So here we can write, according to a radioactive decay law, the value of this mod of dn by dt, the activity must be directly proportional to the number of undecayed nuclei present. These are n. Let's continue on the next sheet. As we have seen, according to decay law, the activity at any instant is proportional to number of undecayed nuclei. So here this dn by dt we can further write as, we just include a proportionality constant with a negative sign, as I have removed the modulus sign. So it will be minus lambda n. And here we can write lambda is a proportionality constant for an element called its decay constant. In next section, we'll talk about this decay constant further. Right now, you just treat it as a constant for every element. And in this situation further, we can analyze this expression as dn by n is equals to minus lambda dt. We are rearranging the terms. And if we integrate it, here you can see at t equals to 0 number of parent nuclei were n naught and at time t these left were n. So on integrating we can see we are getting ln of n with limits from n naught to n, where it is minus lambda dt will be integrated as t only. So this becomes ln of n by n naught. when you substitute the limit, it is ln n minus ln n naught, which can be written as minus lambda t. So it can be rearranged as n is equals to n naught e to power minus lambda t. This is the relation we are getting for number of parent nuclei which are left at time t if the initial number of nuclei were n naught. And as there is a relation in number of nuclei of radioactive element as a function of time, the same can be rearranged in terms of mass of radioactive element also as m is equals to m naught e to power minus lambda t, because mass of a radioactive element or any element is proportional to the number of nuclei in the sample. So this is the same relation which we can deduce for masses. As well as if we multiply left and right both sides with the decay constant lambda, then lambda n will be the activity of radioactive substance at time t, and lambda n naught was the activity at t equals to 0. So this can be further rearranged as activity is equals to activity naught e to power minus lambda t. This is the same relation we can deduce. And all these three relations we call radioactive decay equation, which are deduced according to radioactive decay law, which gives us an idea about the activity, number of radioactive nuclei or the mass of radioactive nuclei as a function of time in terms of initial nuclei, initial mass or initial activity of the substance. So these equations are going to be extremely helpful in handling various numerical applications related to radioactivity. We'll see in upcoming sections.